Hello everyone, this is Revans from Digi Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 232. PUBG New State is set to launch on November 11, 2021 for Android and iOS devices. Krafton has revealed iOS and Android system requirements for PUBG New State. Now let's see about the system requirements for the PUBG New State Android. The operating system should be Android 6.0 or later. It should have a 64-bit CPU. If I talk about the RAM, it should have 2GB or more, and the download size will be varying based upon the devices. Now let's see the system requirements of PUBG New State iOS. It should have an OS of iOS 13 or later, and the downloadable size will be around 1.5 GB. Players who have iPhone 6s or later will be able to run PUBG New State on their device. Battleground Mobile India players can qualify for 2022 Asian Games. Asian Games next year can be held in China between September 10th and 25th. Battleground Mobile India players will be able to fight PUBG Mobile players. Windows 11 Software Edition announced for low-cost laptops. It is designed for schools and students. Laptop with Windows 11 Software Edition will be launched in the coming months. OnePlus Note 2 unit exploded inside victim's jeans pocket. The victim is currently admitted to the hospital following severe second-degree burns. OnePlus India will refund the victim and assures to take care of all the medical expenses. Our Prime Minister Modi ji is placed at number 2 and American singer Taylor Swift is at number 1 spot among the list of 50 most influential people on Twitter this year. According to the reports, Modi came second with 72 million followers on Twitter, and there was no change in his position from last year. And our Indian greatest batsman Sachin Tendulkar is also in the list, placed at number 35. Apple CEO Tim Cook on Tuesday revealed that he is a crypto investor and holds digital coins. Apple CEO shared his thoughts on the hot topic of cryptocurrency such as Bitcoin. However, Cook dismissed the idea of accepting cryptocurrency via Apple Pay anytime soon. He explained that Apple is looking at crypto but has no plans to launch such functionality in Apple Pay. Speaking about the Apple stocks and cryptocurrency, Cook noted that Apple does not have any plans to invest in cryptocurrencies as a company because he believes Apple shareholders do not buy its stock to get exposure to crypto. Union Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari said that the cost of electric vehicles in India will drop to the level of petrol vehicles in next 2 years. Within 2 years, the cost of electric vehicles will come down to a level that will be par with the petrol variants. Already, GST is only 5% on electric vehicles, and the cost of lithium-ion battery is also declining. Besides, the government has already framed a policy allowing petrol pumps to set up electric vehicle charging station. In 2 years, there will be a lot of charging points across in India as well. Again, electric mobility is gaining good momentum in the country. There is no artificial push required. The per kilometer cost of petrol-based vehicle is rupees 10, that of diesel is 7 rupees per kilometer, where for electric vehicles it is around 1 rupee per kilometer. The latest numbers coming out of India in terms of smartwatch shipments indicate that total manufacturers are sustaining a strong overall performance. According to the report, Steam has released its Q3 2021 figures for smartwatch shipments in the Indian market. The report shows the market recorded its highest performance yet during this quarter. The Samsung Exynos Instagram account posted a number of suggestive teasers yesterday, which led everyone to believe that big reveal on November 19th will be new Exynos launch. Today, the company took to Twitter to clarify that no new chipset, not on the 19th anyway. Face ID will not malfunction after performing a third-party screen repair on iPhone 13. Apple is rumored to push a software update to backtrack the irreparability. Apple was found to disable or break Face ID when a screen repair was executed on an iPhone 13. Google flip-flopped on a face unlock fingerprint reader debate, but seemingly settled on having a physical fingerprint reader. Then Pixel 6 and 6 Pro leaks promised the return of face unlocking, only for the official unveiling to make no mention of it. That may have been a last-minute change. Back in July, there was a patch that reduced power usage during face unlocking, a feature codenamed called as Tuscany. Reliance Jio, Bharti Airtel and Vodafone Idea have received a 6-month extension from the Department of Telecommunication to conduct 5G trials till March 2022. The move, though, is set to push the 5G spectrum auction into the second half of 2022. OnePlus 10 series will launch sometime during Q1 2022. Way ahead of the launch, the renders and key specifications of the OnePlus 10 Pro have surfaced. OnePlus 10 Pro will sport a triple rear camera setup. According to the rumors, Oppo launching tablets and laptop this year, but 2021 is almost running out of the companies yet to announce either of those. And while Oppo has not officially mentioned its plans about notebooks and tablets yet, a picture of Oppo tablet has surfaced online. This image does not reveal much about the Oppo Pad, but we can see that its screen does not have a notch in the center or a punch hole in the right side of the selfie camera. Tecno Spark 8 has been launched in India. This phone features a MediaTek Helio G25 chipset, Android 11 OS and a 5000mAh battery. Tecno Spark 8 price in India is set at ₹9,299. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.